Mona Lisa. Everyone's lining up to see her. Right, so hello, my name's Jade Rose. Let's get into the big question, which is why? I used to be one of those people as well. I used to love sweets. Like, to the point where I never really got it when people didn't want a sweet. If I was with a friend and we were both offered like a piece of chocolate or some cake, and they were like, no, I'm okay.
I couldn't understand.
But I have now become one of those people, and I'm gonna tell you how, why, and just my whole experience. So really the main reason why I wanted to quit sugar in the first place was weight loss. First time I started to try and lose weight, I knew that I had to be in a calorie deficit. And to me, calorie deficit just meant, oh, let's count calories. As long as I'm in these certain calories, I'm gonna lose weight. And I counted calories, but you know, I was trying to be smart with it. And smart like in a dumb way, really. And I never really thought about health. I was still in the mindset of, oh, I can still eat ice cream, I can still eat chocolate, I can still eat all the biscuits and apple pie and all that stuff. And obviously, it didn't really work. And it didn't work for two reasons. First being, sugary foods are usually very high in calories. So for the amount of food that you get, there are a lot of calories in that little portion. So I'd start off my day thinking, okay, I really want this ice cream. I'm gonna have ice cream instead of a meal. And as it gets later on, even if it's not later on, even if it's like 3 days later, I would start eating other things that like add on the calories because obviously I'm hungry. Eventually those calories stack up and then you go back to square one. They're like empty calories, calories that literally do nothing for you. That volume of ice cream was never enough to keep me satisfied. Krispy Kremes are not enough to keep anyone satisfied. I used to eat mountains of Cocoa Pops, zero nutritional value and not enough to keep me satisfied. The second reason is sugar spikes your insulin levels, and that prevents you from actually, you know, burning fat and losing weight. And the glucose from the sugar, your body stores glucose as fat. I really think this is the reason why it was so hard for me to lose weight while eating so much sugar. Spiking your insulin up and down also puts you at risk for type 2 diabetes. Which brings me to my next point. When I decided to quit sugar and it actually worked and I actually stuck with it, is because I had a deeper reason than, oh, I just want to lose weight. Type 2 diabetes actually runs in my family. When I realized how much sugar is linked to type 2 diabetes, something just like clicked in my brain. To really create any real change, any solid change that you're going to stick to and it just be a lifetime thing, to lose weight, to stop bad eating habits, there needs to be a real reason why. And my reason of, oh, I want to lose weight because this person is fat shaming me and my friends are all skinnier than me, those were not reasons. But that was all coming from a place of negativity as well. I mean, not just body shaming from other people, but body shaming myself. Telling myself like, oh, I'm the biggest person out of my friendship group. Oh, I hate my stomach. Oh, I can't fit into this size. I mean, all those things
are so negative and just so...
I just don't really mean anything. I was trying to go against my body, like fighting my body, and that's not where real change comes from. I had tried reducing my sugar before because of those reasons, and it didn't really work. The only thing that really worked is when I started actually researching about the dangers of type 2 diabetes. I now know how much of a killer it is, especially in black and brown communities. It's an epidemic that is slowly killing us. It makes you feel weak, it makes you look older. I mean, you can lose limbs, and just those things kind of just shocked me into,
okay, I need to reduce my sugar.
It's just crazy. I mean, sugar cannot be a primary food group in my diet. Even if diabetes doesn't run your family, it's not something that you really care about or really are worried about. In general, these like high sugar diets spike and then drop your energy levels. So it makes you feel really tired. It can affect your skin. It can, you know, give you acne and also age you. I mean, what's the point of us buying all these like, you know, nice skin creams and, you know, little serums here and there if you're eating like bucket loads of sugary junk food? So for me, I had to quit cold turkey. Because once I had that little bit, I could not stop. The hard part was actually figuring out what had sugar in it and what didn't. I mean, for years, I didn't realize that croissants had sugar in it. I didn't really see it as a sugary treat. I saw it as a standard in a Congolese person's diet. So yeah, I started with the obvious stuff. Cakes, sweets, candy. Was it hard at first? Of course, it's hard to change any eating habits, but especially when it comes to sugar. I mean, there are studies that say sugar is just as addictive as cocaine. Plus, if you go a little bit deeper into it, I mean, there can be like a emotional attachment to that food as well. Especially when it comes to sugar, I mean, you eat, you know, cake on birthdays. You might have like, you know, loads of chocolate on Christmas or Easter. So you relate that emotion of happiness and fun to, you know, sweets. After cutting out the obvious stuff, I went for the not so obvious stuff. Like I started really trying to figure out, what has sugar in it? I stopped drinking any kind of juices, only water, because I realized so many fruit juices, it was hard to tell what was real fruit and what was, you know, just sugar. Pasta sauces, ketchup, I stopped eating ketchup. It's like a Nando sauce, hot sauce, there are so many different sauces that don't have that excessive amount of sugar in them. So substitutes, definitely went for substitutes. So I switched out real sugar for a sweetener. I know there's someone that's gonna say, oh, sweetener is worse than sugar and blah, 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 blah. But in my experience, it's not. I would add it to some things to kind of just satisfy, you know, that sweet tooth. I personally wouldn't recommend using it all the time because sometimes you get, again, addicted to that sweet flavor. So you wanna eat the same thing over and over again. And that thing that you put the sweetener in also has calories, you know? So if you have, I don't know, a replacement protein bar that has like all sweetener and not sugar, yeah, if you have one of those, that's great, that's a great replacement. If you have three of them, then no, it's not. I mean, you might as well have had a Snickers bar. There was a time where, I don't know why, I would eat multiple protein bars. I really feel like the reason why a lot of people eat so much sugar and it's quite appealing is because it's easy. It's easily packaged. You get the, you know, chocolate bars. You get, you know, the cakes at bakeries. It's just easy and it's kind of cheap. So instead of having snacks, you know, wherever I went, like whatever was offered to me, I would have my own snacks on the go that I knew that were low in sugar and they were good for me. Protein shakes, I love protein shakes. They keep me really full, they're really satisfying, and they do satisfy that sweet tooth as well. With no added sugar, if you, you know, use the right protein. So if you go for the protein with maybe half a banana, so that is sugar, but like, you know, natural sugars, then you can add milk, usually like hazelnut milk is nice, or almond milk. And I also add a bit of P2B powder, which is like a powdered peanut butter. And obviously there are ways that you can kind of like vary the protein shake. You can put them in the ice lolly containers and have lollies like for the whole week. You can make it super thick and then make an ice cream out of it, which is so good. To me, I can't even taste the difference between the protein ice cream and normal ice cream. Fruit as well. Fruit are an amazing substitute. They are still high in sugar, even though it's natural sugar. So I wouldn't eat like fruit all day, but the natural sugar is not anything like, you know, the added sugar. They are super healthy, and honestly, at first I thought that sugar was sugar, right? So I thought that I couldn't eat fruit. Now that I know what I know now, I really think it would have benefited me if I actually ate fruit as well, because I would have that as an option. The best kind of fruits to eat that are a bit more lower on the sugar range are blueberries, watermelon, strawberries, any kind of berry is good. Normal melon as well is really good. The fruit that is more high on the sugar content are like mango, lychee, passion fruit, very tropical fruits, even banana actually. Banana is quite high in sugar, which is why even in my protein shake, I do kind of portion control the banana. Like, yeah, bananas are still healthy and still great for you and better than most other things anyway. So I still eat bananas, but obviously I wouldn't have like 3 bananas in a day. Again, though, fruit is always gonna be a better option than most things. So, I mean, if all you have in your house is like a yogurt with, you know, the little chocolate balls or mango, I would go for the mango. It's easy to get in this like extreme mindset, like I can only eat broccoli and lean protein and that's it. And then I eat all of that until about 7 p.m. and you end up eating half a whole apple pie. And actually, if you just allowed yourself to have, you know, a bit of mango earlier in the day, you wouldn't have had those cravings for the apple pie. Maybe when you start off, if you have like intense sugar cravings, have that kind of list of things that you know that you can go to. 2 or 3 things that are quick, easy, will satisfy those cravings, and you don't have to, you know, go and eat half the apple pie. Again, it was really hard at first, but after a while, honestly, you forget it even exists. Quitting sugar actually forced me to break that emotional bond that I had with sugar and actually, you know, forced me to try new foods and love new foods. Loving real foods, real meals, and not just like waiting on the sugary snack or dessert that I was gonna have. Obviously now I love vegetables, and you guys know I love vegetables, but then I was not a fan. Before, I thought that vegetables were just like iceberg lettuce and cucumber, and I was like, why would you like that? But obviously I started exploring different kinds of foods, different kinds of vegetables, different, even salads, right? There are different cultures that have amazing kind of salads. There's like a Turkish kind of tabbouleh salad, a Cypriot style salads with like halloumi, Italian kind of salads with like, you know, the balsamic vinegar, even different types of vegetables, aubergine, courgettes, mushrooms. I turned myself from being a sweet tooth to actually really, really enjoying real food the same way I was enjoying all the sugary stuff. And I didn't need to have sugar to feel like I was having something amazing, like a really nice snack that I enjoyed. So much more to loving food than like cake and chocolate. And I would never have really known that if I didn't, you know, break away from that, break away from those habits, break away from that mindset. Sugar is not a primary food group. And when you're eating more sugar than your, you know, actual necessary food groups, that's a problem. So for me, quitting sugar resulted in weight loss, sustainable, healthy weight loss, being able to fit in the clothes that I wanted, looking better, and obviously lowering my risk of type 2 diabetes. Hopefully my skin will be nice when I'm old too, and hopefully it adds a few more years onto my life as well. So what's happening with me now? I'm still maintaining a slim figure for, you know, a long time now, but I'm not as like super strict as I was before. I think because I've been slim for a while, that little bit isn't gonna make such a difference over a small amount of time. It's more of if I decided to, you know, eat cake every day over the course of time, maybe then I would start gaining weight. I do have the occasional dessert, but I know they're high in sugar, so I portion control it. So when I go out with my friends, we'll like split a cheesecake after dinner. Or like when I went to Italy, for example, I had some gelato. Obviously when in Italy, you have to have some gelato. So I had one scoop in a little pot instead of having the two scoops on the, you know, honey glazed waffle cone. I can eat in moderation now. I don't have like that bond to sugar that I used to. And I just think I really needed that time of having absolutely no sugar to realize that I enjoyed other foods just as much. That was my experience. Let me know about how you feel about sugar. Have you ever tried cutting sugar out or reducing sugar? What were your results? Were you able to lose weight cutting out sugar? Are there any kind of other effects that sugar has on you? If you liked the video, you feel like it wasn't a complete waste of your time and it was worth watching, please do like the video. For me, I actually measure my success on the video based on likes. If you've taken the time to go and like the video, that really means something, you know. If you want more tips on addressing bad eating habits and kind of all the fundamentals that you need to know before you, you know, put together a really good diet plan, definitely watch this video. It's called The Only Two Diets You'll Ever Need. I'll see you in that video.